In this video, we are going to learn about some examples of inverse trigonometric functions. In my previous video, already I have explained about the derivatives for standard inverse trigonometric functions. You could find the link for that video is given in the description below. Now, we will solve some examples of inverse trigonometric functions. Let's get started. First example, differentiate sine inverse of 3x minus 4x cube. So here we have sine inverse of 3x minus 4x cube. So now we have to differentiate this equation with respect to some x. Okay. Before that, first we are assuming it as this equation as y. So y equal to sine inverse of 3x minus 4x cube. Okay. This inverse type of problems we have to solve only by using substitution method. That is, in the place of x, we have to substitute some value, and then only it's very easy to solve this inverse type of problems. So for that, we have to use trigonometric formulas, that is trigonometric identities. Okay. In this problem, we are going to use the trigonometric formula, that is sine 3 theta equal to 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta. Why we are using this formula? That is, in this given problem, we have 3x minus 4x cube, right? So this is of the form 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta. Okay. So in this problem, in the place of x, we are assuming sine theta. So if you assume x equal to sine theta, this is of the form 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta. So this equation will become y equal to sine inverse of 3 into, in the place of x, I am just substituting sine theta. So 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta, because x cube, right? So sine cube theta. So this is nothing but y equal to sine inverse of, so what is this equation 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta? That is nothing but sine 3 theta, right? So sine 3 theta. So now this equation will become, the sine and sine inverse will get cancelled, right? Sine inverse here, and here we have sine 3 theta. So this sine and sine inverse will get cancelled. So we have y equal to 3 theta. So what is theta? So from this equation, so we have x equal to sine theta, right? So what is theta? Taking this sine to the other side, it will become sine inverse of x. So theta value is sine inverse of x. So y equal to 3 into, in the place of theta, we have to write it as sine inverse of x. So y equal to 3 into sine inverse of x. So far we have done only the substitution. Now we have to differentiate this y equation with respect to x. Okay. So differentiating y with respect to x. So left hand side, that is dy by dx equal to 3 is constant into sine inverse of x. So sine inverse of x derivative is 1 divided by root of 1 minus x square. Therefore the answer is 3 divided by, just multiplying 3 here, 1 into 3, that is 3 divided by root of 1 minus x square. So this is the answer. Next example, differentiate cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. So first we have to assume the equation, it has some y. So let y equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. So now we have to use the trigonometric formula, that is, so in this given problem, we have 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. So I am going to use the trigonometric formula, that is cos 2 theta equal to 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. So now I am using this trigonometric formula, that is cos 2 theta formula, because this is of the form 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. In the place of x, we have tan. So in this problem, we have to assume x value as tan theta. Now substitute x equal to tan theta in the y value, that is y equal to cos inverse of 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. So this is y equal to cos inverse of, so this is nothing but cos 2 theta. Now this cos inverse and cos value will get cancelled. So we have y equal to 2 theta. So what is theta value? So from this equation, theta equal to tan inverse of x, right? Because I am taking this tan to the other side, it will become tan inverse of x. So in the place of theta, we have to substitute tan inverse of x. So y value is 2 into tan inverse of x. Now we have to differentiate this y with respect to x. So I am differentiating y with respect to x. So this left hand side will become dy by dx equal to, so right hand side we have 2 into tan inverse of x. So 2 is constant, tan inverse of x. Tan inverse of x derivative is 1 divided by 1 plus x square. So the answer is 2 divided by 1 plus x square. Next, third example, differentiate secant inverse of 1 plus x square by 1 minus x square. Okay, so first we have to assume the given problem as some y. So y equal to secant inverse of 1 plus x square by 1 minus x square. So this is again, that is what we did in the previous problem. So the only difference is, in the previous problem we have 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square, but here we have 1 plus x square by 1 minus x square. So we have to use the same formula here, that is cos 2 theta equal to 1 minus tan square divided by 1 plus tan square theta. So we have to use this formula because the given problem is in the form of 1 plus x square by 1 minus x square. But in this trigonometric formula, we have 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta. So now we have to take reciprocal. So left hand side will become 1 divided by cos 2 theta equal to, if you take reciprocal, this will become 1 plus tan square theta by 1 minus tan square theta. Now we have to substitute in the place of x, we have tan theta. So I am just substituting x equal to tan theta. So the y equation will become secant inverse of 1 plus tan square theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta. So this is y equal to secant inverse of, what is this 1 plus tan square theta by 1 minus tan square theta? That is nothing but 1 divided by cos 2 theta. So 1 divided by cos 2 theta. Therefore y equal to secant inverse of, so 1 by cos theta is nothing but secant theta, right? So in the place of 1 by cos 2 theta, we have to write it as secant 2 theta. So this secant and secant inverse will get cancelled. So we have y equal to 2 theta. So what is theta? Now we have to use this x value, that is x equal to tan theta, right? So theta equal to tan inverse of x. So therefore 2 into tan inverse of x. So y equal to 2 into tan inverse of x. Now we have to differentiate this y. Differentiating y with respect to x. So the left hand side will become dy by dx equal to 2 into, 2 is constant, so therefore 2 into tan inverse of x differentiation, that is 1 divided by 1 plus x square. So therefore the answer is 2 divided by 1 plus x square. So this is how we have to find the derivatives of inverse trigonometric functions. Thanks for watching this video. If you find this video useful, please subscribe to my channel and click on like button. And for further notification, please hit the bell icon. Thank you.